You don't have to be a Christian to believe that there is life after death. The belief in life after death can be found also in Islam, in Judaism, and the many other religions of Asia. We all believe in some form that there is a life waiting for us when this life on earth is over. For other religions, you can take the belief in reincarnation. So life continues even if you die. Or for us, it is heaven, hell, or purgatory. There is still life beyond this life. For some people, it is a conscious living. For some people, it is entering into a different kind of consciousness. For example, there are some people who believe that when you die, like a droplet of water, you are dropped into the ocean and then you find your meaning. That is still belief in life after death. But for us Christians, we are not believers in reincarnation. We are not believers in karma. We are believers that after this death, we still live. After this death, we still live in a new kind of life. And that new kind of life is what we will profess later. We call it communion of saints. What do we mean when we believe in communion of saints? What we mean is this, that even if we die, our bodies die, we still live, we don't die. We believe that when we die, we enter into communion with those who have already died. We are still in communication with those we have left behind, and we are in communion with God, the Divine, Jesus Christ, who opens for us life everlasting. So when we die, we enter into communion with those who have died already. When we die, we are still in communication with those we leave behind. And when we die, we continue our living in friendship with the Divine, with our Lord Jesus Christ. Now the question needs to be asked, but what kind of life? You tell me they are alive, but why can't we talk to them? You tell me that they are still living, but we buried them. So what kind of life? How can we communicate with those who have died ahead of us? Three things, my dear brothers and sisters. You remember in the Gospel, when the Lord died on the cross, the Gospel said, the curtain of the temple was torn from top to bottom, and the graves were opened. In other words, you will not be able to communicate with the saints. You will not be able to communicate with the dead. You will not be able to link with those who have died outside of Jesus Christ. It is only through Jesus Christ that we can communicate with the dead. It is only through Jesus Christ that we are linked to the dead. It is only through Him. It is not by the spirit of the glass. It is not by the fortune teller. It is not by those who look at the crystal ball. It is not by those who look at the stars. It is not about horoscope. It is only through Jesus Christ that we can communicate with the faithful departed. It is only through Jesus Christ that we can communicate with the saints. So the question is, how? The answer is, through Jesus and only Him. The second question is, where? Again, you remember in the Gospel, the Lord said, meet me in Galilee. meet me in Galilee. Galilee is not a town in the map. Galilee is a symbol. Galilee is the place where they fell in love with the Lord. Galilee is the place where their dreams were born. Galilee is the place where their souls grew. Galilee is the place where their hearts grew. Galilee is the place where they found their passion. Galilee is the place where they started to dream and make those dreams come true. So in other words, my dear brothers and sisters, where will you find the dead? Not in the cemetery. They are not dead. The dead are not in the cemetery. The dead are in Galilee. We will meet the Lord in their Galilee. And the Galilee is where they were happiest, where they were best, where they were most beautiful, where their heart was largest, where their spirit was biggest, where their dream was the most beautiful dream to pursue. The Galilee of our lives is where we are at our best. And when we look at our best, you will also see your loved ones there. How? Through Jesus. Where? In our symbolic Galilee, where our dreams were born, where our love was nurtured, where our life was nourished, where our vision was set, where our favorites are. And then the third question is, with whom? And the answer is, with our brothers and sisters. In other words, we do not communicate with the faithful departed. We do not communicate with the saints like they are scary ghosts. We communicate with them as brothers and sisters because they are still alive. Because of this pandemic, we are prevented from going to the cemetery. Maybe the prohibition not to go to the cemetery is providential so that we may be reminded that the dead are not in the cemetery. The dead are not in their graves. The dead are not in the tombs. In fact, the tomb is empty. The grave is empty. Why? Because the Lord is risen, and those who believe in the Lord will never die. Those who believe in the Lord live forever. We are not able to visit the cemetery because we are not men and women of the cemetery. We are not able to go to the graves and to the tombs because we are not believers of the grave and the tomb. We are not able to go there because we know that that tomb does not carry our loved ones. Because our loved ones live forever in the Galilee of our dreams, with the Lord whom we adore, and in our brothers and sisters. I say it again, my dear brothers and sisters, our loved ones who have died are not in the tomb. We are not men and women of the cemetery, because God is God of the living. And those who worship the Lord, those who believe in the Lord, those who eat the body and blood of the Lord, have life everlasting waiting for us. Our destiny is not the grave. Our conclusion is not the tomb. Our life has no conclusion because it is forever.